Hello Internet, welcome to another tutorial in Digital Electronics series. We'll discuss NOR gate as universal gate today. We've already covered NAND gate as universal gate. So if you watched my previous video, the objective of this video is to formulate all the other gates using NOR gate, and that is what will make NOR gate as a universal gate. So what we've got here is we've got enough NOR gates with us, and we need to fabricate all the other gates from it. First things first, the simplest gate is the NOT gate or the inverter. And you could make a NOT gate from NOR gate by shorting the two inputs. And at the output, you'll get A plus A bar, which is, of course, A bar. So that is how you will make a NOT gate from NOR gate. In order to make an OR gate, you'd require two NOR gates. So the first NOR gate has two inputs A and B. The output of the first NOR gate will be A plus B whole bar. And if this output of first NOR gate is treated as an input to the second NOR gate, which is acting as an inverter, it will simply rub off this whole bar inversion of A plus B, and we'll get an inverted A plus B, which is desired. So A plus B is desired out of this circuit in order to make it a OR gate. Then we have AND gate. AND gate is made out of three NOR gates. So the first NOR gate will act as an inverter to invert the input A. The second NOR gate will act as an inverter to invert B, and then we'll have A bar plus B bar and whole bar. And if we apply De Morgan's theorem, the first term multiplied by the second term, and their bars are individual, so we get A dot B, which is the expression for AND gate. And making a NAND gate is pretty simple. You could put another inverter here. So if you were to make a NAND gate out of an OR gate, you would simply use the same arrangement and put an inverter NOR gate here. So you've already gotten A, B here, and if you invert it, it will give us the expression for the NAND gate. And finally, we have the most complicated of all gates, the XOR gate, which can also be realized using NOR gates, and it'll take us six NOR gates to realize an XOR gate. And once an XOR gate is realized, we can simply once an XOR gate is realized, we can simply put an inverter at this stage to make it an XNOR. So I'll do the expression for XOR gate. So we have A here, B here. This A will be inverted by gate number 2, and this B will be inverted by gate number 1. Then the output of gate number 3 will be A plus B bar whole bar, and the output of gate number 4 will be B plus A bar whole bar. Now if you were to solve this A plus B bar whole bar using De Morgan's theorem, it will be individual terms multiplied and a bar on the individual terms. So that will give me A bar B here. And similarly, if you apply De Morgan's theorem here, so that will be individual terms multiplied and bar on individual terms. So that will be B bar A or AB bar. Now please understand, these two are the inputs to gate number 5. So we need to analyze the output of gate number 5. So the output of gate 5 will be A bar B plus AB bar. Please understand, the output of gate 5 is A bar B plus AB bar whole bar. And if we invert this entire thing via gate number 6, it will be A bar B plus AB bar, which is the desired output for the XOR gate. And if we further invert this, we'll get XNOR. So XNOR can be made by putting an additional NOR gate in the inverting configuration. So we simply need to take up this output of gate number 5 and invert it to get the desired output. And that is how you can use NOR gate as a universal gate to fabricate or make all the other gates. I hope this tutorial was of help, and thank you so much for watching the videos in the series and supporting the channel. You have a great day ahead. Goodbye.